All right, guys. I know it's been a while. Six String here. I've been meaning to get this review out forever. I've just had a bunch of major life issues. But I want to talk to you guys about this, the Through Night. This thing is a powerhouse. Thing's awesome. It's a extremely high end for as far as lumens, 830 lumen. Awesome light. Let me take this off. I just have that on there to make it easier to grip onto. But it has one of my favorite parts about the light. Again, there's plenty of vids on this out there. One of my favorite parts is about how simple it is in the location of the buttons. It's just, you know, you've got one. Here, let me get it back to zero. So it's got a low, medium, high, and then strobe. And, you know, you can hold it in there. Does that? It's a great strobe. If you leave it on high, shut it off, then turn it on. It's got the momentary on. And the thing is, you know, I have the PD32 and the old PD30s. I'm a flashlight whore. It's got a very, very easy to actuate light. Very quiet, even when you click it. And the fact that the mode button is right here, and if you just hit the mode button, it goes right to strobe. Okay, also, and it's just easy that's where you want to change it. This thing's like the worst design ever on this Phoenix, I can't even tell you. I mean, it's nice and all, but also, as you can see, I kind of like, you know, compact lights. I always thought those were the, you know, way to go, and that's why I like the 30 so much. It wasn't until I actually had this that I realized that you have to go to a wider head to get your the amount of beam flood and what have you. And this thing is just awesome. And, you know, weird thing when it comes to lumens, you know, this thing gets up there. Once you go there, all these look dark. So, you have to kind of go that way. It does have, let me show you a couple of things here. It does come with a couple of extensions, so you can put actually up to four CR123 batteries in there. But the threads are nice, flat threads, and that's going to promote longevity. Certainly the O-washers, and they come with a little bit of grease in there, which is always a good thing. And, you have to take your the washer out to put on the deal, but I like that this comes off. Also, most of these lights are always, you know, these things are just going to scratch your light up. But the nice thing is, again, especially if you take the washer off, you can just slide this on. There you go. It's the easiest to put on clip of any light in the business. That's for sure. Okay, now another neat thing. As this also can get, and this just does for the turbo high, you can get the telephone cord style remote switches. These aren't that easy to come by lately, so I really appreciate that. So this can go on my shotgun and do that sort of deal. But I don't know what to tell you other than it's just an awesome light. You know, you're paying well under $100 for it. I believe you can find it on Amazon. I've seen it on eBay, but they got a pretty neat line, and this has become one of my primary lights. I mean, this is the SHTF light. This is what you need. I have had to send the Phoenixes back, one of them, and you know, they tend to be. And I'm not happy with those, not like I am with this. The other neat little through night is this. This is their, the TI-2. And again, they actually bought out, this is from, they make PowerTech. And I had this already, and this is great because it's one of the only little pen lights that has a low and high. And I'm not sure the deal here. You can see the colors are slightly different. And this is, you know, I talked to the rep, and he said that they did buy these out. And maybe it's because the color. But I can tell you this. These, Through Night sells for a few dollars cheaper than PowerTech does. This is the ultimate in keychain lights. I mean, having that Firefly setting and the high, and it's got a, it's, I mean, this, the beam on this thing is as good as an old Maglite, seriously. So, again, I'm not, there's a ton of info out there on these, so I just, you know, didn't know other than to say that I really enjoy this light. And, oh, it will fit. Oh, sorry about that. It will fit in the new Magpul rail light mounts. This is that new Magpul. And you can put a Scout on there. This one happens to be a primary arms light, but it's the same diameter as the Thru Knight. And so it will fit on there. And that'll give, because it's hard to find a mount for this, because it's kind of big. But it doesn't weigh a hell of a lot either. And I like that it has, it's not as much of a flood. I am a spot type of person. And this thing does both. And it's just, it's impressive. And, oh, it also comes with a really nice case. I always embellish everything. Again, something like this you want a case for. And this actually is usable. And what I like about the case is not only has it got Velcro, a snap, and the loop goes under that too. So there's just no, you can put it on a belt, or you can molly it, or whatever you want. It's actually a really good case, and with an odd light like that, with the big head and the smaller, you know, body, you definitely need something. But I'm impressed with them. I will be getting more Thru Knight lights in the future. Again, once you get up over 500 lumens, you're just never going to turn back. And you know, now that technology allows it to be well under $100, you're crazy if you don't own something like this. And I know there's a lot of reverse snobbery, so to speak, in the flashlight world, but you can't tell me that a light is not the second most important thing after a gun, or a light on a gun. I mean, this, especially in the New England area where I am, I mean, it gets dark out at 4:30 these days, and doesn't get sunny, it doesn't, the sun doesn't come up till after 5. A flashlight is ultra important. So the Corellium part comes off too, if you want to do that, if you need to. These things are completely weapon-proof, recoil-proof, what have you, but really nice finish. I did recently get, or had access to, a Surefire Defender, and I like this better than the Defender. I did the Scout 600, the M600U, the Ultra at 500, which is excellent, and then I thought the Defender would be like, the Defender was kind of odd. This for me, at half the price and a much higher lumen output, was the way to go. So and you decide it will, if you want to, you know, put the extra sections in. I've done it, but it's almost as bright, or it is as bright for me with just the two, and that's why I like to run them. And Christ, this still has the original batteries in it, and I've had it for several months, and that's impressive in itself. All right. So, again, just another nice, another company doing good things for a good price. And I do recommend that you guys give Thru Knight a consideration. You know, there is a lot of videos out there for a reason, because it's a nice setup.